Assalamu alaikum class, I hope you all are fine. In the previous lecture, we studied about the low birth weight babies and we did two classifications of low birth weight babies. One was according to the gestational age and the other one was regardless of gestational age. We also studied about the prevention of low birth weight babies, and in this we did the direct intervention measures as well as the direct interventions which can help in prevention. Now coming to the treatment of this problem, the babies with the weight less than 2.5 kgs is divided into two groups. One of the group, it comprises of those infants who are born under 2 kgs of weight, and the other group comprises of those infants who are born between 2 to 2.5 kgs of weight. Now those who are born under 2 kgs of weight, usually they require neonatal intensive care for a longer period of time. And the other group, that is between 2 to 2.5 kg, may require intensive care therapy for a day or two, and kangaroo mother care is given to them. And in this lecture, we'll discuss in detail about the kangaroo mother care. Now the concept of kangaroo mother care for the low birth weight babies, that is who weigh between 2 to 2.5 kgs, was introduced in a hospital of Columbia in 1979 by Dr. Hedker and Dr. Edzer. Now in that hospital, the infection rate was very high, the attendance in the antenatal unit was very less, and the perinatal mortality rate was high, and the incidence of low birth weight delivery was also high. So the equipment was also very less to give proper support or care to those low birth weight babies. So they developed this model and gave a concept of this kangaroo mother care. Now this concept, usually it is based on the baby of the kangaroo, which is Joey. As it, you all know, it stays in the pouch of the mother for the maintenance of temperature, for safety, and a constant supply of milk. Now when the baby is able to feed and it stabilizes its body temperature and feels secure outside, it starts going out of that pouch and it roams around. So this concept was given to the mothers to take care of these low birth weight babies, in which there was skin to skin positioning of the baby to the mother, and this promoted the health and well-being of that low birth weight baby. The kangaroo mother care concept has been adopted in the developing countries and is widely practiced for the neonatal care. Now the four important components of kangaroo mother care are: number one, the skin to skin positioning of the baby on the mother's chest, and the baby is put on the mother's chest and the head is on one side so that the airway passage is not obstructed, and this is done 4 to 5 times a day, and a wrap is put on the baby. And the skin to skin positioning, it stabilizes the heart and the respiratory rate of the baby and improves its oxygen saturation, and it also regulates the body temperature of the baby. Now next important component is the nutrition of the baby, and which is exclusively done by breastfeeding on demand of the baby. The third important component is the ambulatory care, which is provided to the mother if she wants to go home earlier. Now before the mother goes home, she is properly counseled and educated about the kangaroo mother care, how she should practice it as home as well, and the proper counseling and support is also provided to the husband and the family as well, so as the mother also is given proper support by the family to provide kangaroo mother care at home. Now the mother comes to the hospital regularly for the follow-up of the baby, and the growth of the baby is monitored. And when it reaches to 2.5 kgs of weight or above that weight, the mother is told to stop the kangaroo care. And the other group, as we discussed earlier in this lecture, was that the babies who are born under 2 kgs of weight. For that type of low birth weight babies, intensive care is required for a longer period of time. As you know, in the intensive care unit, in nurseries, in the hospitals, you must have seen that there's incubators. So incubatory care is very important. In incubatory care, there is adjustment of the temperature, humidity, and oxygen support is given to the babies. Now, as you know, the subcutaneous fat is very less in these babies and their skin is very thin. So adjustment of temperature is very important. And now the oxygen supply should also be maintained. Now, when there is more oxygen, it can lead to retrolenter fibroplasia. And if the oxygen is less, that is, there is hypoxia, it can produce a cerebral palsy. So proper continuous monitoring of the level of oxygen in these babies' bloodstream is very important. So this is about the incubatory care. So along with that, feeding is also maintained. As the baby is very weak and cannot suck, so feeding is also done by the nasal catheter. If breastfeeding is not available, then artificial feeding is used. Now, next is the prevention of infections. As these babies are very weak and their immune system is not very well developed, so they are more prone to infections like respiratory infections or GIT infections, and death can occur within a few hours if they get infected with any sort of respiratory disease or any diarrheal disease. So prevention of infections is very important in these babies as well. Now, this was all regarding the treatment of the low birth weight babies. As an examination point of view, you can get a SEQ question on kangaroo mother care, or even you can ask to write the components of kangaroo mother care. So this is all about the treatment of low birth weight babies. Now, next are the leading causes of deaths in low birth weight babies. Now, the leading causes of deaths in low birth weight babies are, number one is the atelectasis. As you know, atelectasis is the collapse or a closure of a lung, which results in reduce or absence of gas exchange. Now, as you know, the lungs of the babies are low birth weight babies, especially, are not very well developed, and there is lack of surfactant in them, and respiratory distress syndrome develops. So the death can be due to atelectasis in these low birth weight babies. Now, another cause of death in low birth weight babies is the malformations. Now, malformations can also occur in these babies and can be a leading cause of death. Another cause of death is the pulmonary hemorrhage. As I told you, the lungs, they are unable to expand properly, and there is lack of surfactant in them, and respiratory distress syndrome can occur. So pulmonary hemorrhage can occur and can cause death. Now, another important cause of deaths in these babies is the intracranial hemorrhage or intracranial bleeding. Now, if the oxygen supply in the bloodstream of babies is less, or we can say if there is hypoxia, this can cause cerebral palsy, or it can lead to intracranial bleeding as well. So intracranial bleed can lead to death. Another important cause of death is in these babies is the infections. Most commonest infection is the pneumonia. So when you are asked about the causes of deaths in low birth weight babies, these are the important five causes which can lead to death in these babies. Now we have completed the newborn care, and I'll give you a brief account of the integrated reproductive maternal newborn child health and nutrition program, which is run by the government of Punjab. Now this program, it basically focuses to reduce the maternal newborn and child morbidity and mortality, and it promotes the family planning services and improve the nutritional status of women and children. Now the basic goal of this program, as I told you, is to improve the maternal, newborn and child health in the Punjab, and especially of the poor in the rural areas and in the urban slums, by reducing the maternal mortality ratio and the under 5 mortality rate, and by decreasing the prevalence of stunting in this province. Now the main objectives of the program is to improve access to the reproduction health, child health and the nutritional services in the province, especially for the poor, by improving the contraceptive prevalence rate in this province, by increasing the skilled birth attendants, and by increasing the institutional deliveries, and by increasing the coverage of immunization in the province, and also by increasing the percentage of exclusive breastfeeding in the pregnant females, and also by increasing the utilization of adequately iodized salt at the household level. And so these are the basic objectives of this program. Now the you achieve these goals and objectives by implementing certain strategies. Now the strategies which are being implemented are that the district health system is strengthened through the integration of quality reproductive, maternal, newborn, child health and nutritional service at the community level, especially at the BHU, RHC, THQ, at the district health quarter level, and especially focusing on the rural areas and the urban slums. And it also implements the strategies to strengthen the linkages of the community-based health services with the health facilities by the LHWs and the CMWs. And so it also focuses on the implementation of strategies so that the IMOC services, as you know, the IMOC services, you must have done them by in detail in Dr. Iram's lecture. So IMOC services are also streamlined and strengthened throughout the provinces, in the province of Punjab. So these are the basic important goals, objectives and strategies of these of this program. And so by implementing these strategies, you improve the maternal, newborn, child health and nutrition of the mothers and the adolescent girls, and also of the newborns and the children as well.